नमस्ते बच्चों, मैं सेल JVN डॉक्टर मोनिका त्रिवेदी। आई एम फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एजुकेशन एंड मेथोडोलॉजी, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर। टुडेज टॉपिक इज 18 इलेक्ट्रॉन रूल एंड EAN नंबर रूल। सो स्टूडेंट्स, द 18 इलेक्ट्रॉन रूल इज फॉर the transition element. We have to discuss today the 18 electron rule for the transition elements. Okay, as we all know that the main group element obeys the octane rule, which is used to predict the formula of covalent compound. Okay, and this rule assumes that the central atom in a compound will make bond, such as the total number of electron around the central atom is 8. Okay, this is the maximum capacity of the s and p orbital. Okay, this rule only valid for period 2, which are non-metallic elements. The 18 electron rule is based on similar concept. Okay, so in this rule, the central transition metal can accommodate the electrons in s, p and d orbital. In s orbital, it can occupy 2, in p orbital, it can occupy 6, and the d orbital occupied 10 electrons. So maximum 18 electrons can occupied by the transition metal atom. Okay, this means that the transition metal can add electrons from Lewis base or ligands in addition to its valence electron to a total of 18 electron. Okay, this is also known as effective atomic number rule. Okay, and it is not apply for the higher oxidation state, it is only applied for the low oxidation state complexes. Now to determine the 18 electron rule, you have to firstly you have to identify the oxidation state of a metal, central metal, electronic configuration of a metal, electrons from the ligands, how much ligand contributed to the metal atom from the ligand, electrons from a metal, and the total electrons. Okay, in these two examples you can find the effective atomic number from calculating these numbers of oxidation state, electronic configuration, electrons from the ligand, electrons from the metal, and the total electron you can calculate from this. The compound and the electrons, the EAN rule, what is the compound, the coordination compound, and what is the EAN rule. Okay, the electronic configuration are completely unrelated to the EAN rule. The central metal may have more than and less than of 18 electrons. Okay, the electronic configuration follows the EAN rule, and it never have less than 18 electrons, but it may have the less. A group of that follow the 18 electron rules are unstable compounds which don't follow the EAN rule, are those compounds which are mostly unstable. Now the sandwich compounds obey the EAN rule. Each of these ligands is a pi bonded and are bonded with this above metal atom. Okay, like ferrocene. Okay, the ferrocene is a sandwich compound. Now the second is half sandwich compound. They are also obey the EAN rule with CO, NO, H and P, R3. These are the ligand which combine together with the central metal ion, and it follows the 18 electron rule. Also, some other cyclic ligands follows the EAN rule. Okay, now how to calculate the EAN rule? Firstly, we have to calculate the oxidation state and electronic configuration of the outermost shell of the transition metal. And after that, you can see here the examples of first is a nickel CO4. Its oxidation state is zero here, and total 10 electrons present in a nickel zero. And for this, two electrons of each carbonyl ligand given to the nickel central metal. And the total of this is 18, okay, because the four ligands are present, so you have to put here the 2 into 4, which is 8, and the nickel have 10, so the 10 plus 8 is equals to 18. So this molecule obeys the 18 electron rule. Okay, secondly, PtCl2 PME3 hole twice. Okay, in this complex, the Pt has a plus 2 oxidation state and 8 electrons in it, and the chlorine gives 2 electron for each, and each of the this ligand, okay, and the PME3 gives the 2 electrons, okay. So there is the 8 plus 4 plus 4, so the total is 16. So this complex don't follow the 18 electrons rule. Okay, now the third one is TaMe5. In this, the Ta have a plus 5 oxidation state and 0 electrons in their orbital, and the Me has a 2 electron for each, total 10 electron. So this will also not follow the 18 electron rule. The last example is a Fe neta 5 C5H5 hole twice. Okay, this is a ferrocene, this is a sandwich compound which follows the 18 electron rule. So by this method, you can calculate the EAN number of each complex, and you can know that the you can find that the particular complex follows the 18 electron rule or not. Okay, so another example, like MnCO 5. Okay, this is the MnCO5 carbonyl compound. Okay, in this you can see here that the Mn have a outer electrons. I have a 7 electron in it, and the carbonyl compound give the 10 electrons, and the total of these is 17. So this will not obey the 18 electrons, but in a dimer of Mn2CO10, it will give have the effective atomic number 18, and it will follow the 18 electron rule. Here you can calculate the electrons of Mn, the contribution of ligands, which is 5 and 2 4 each, so it is 10, and one metal bond here, so the total of is 18, and it will obey the 18 electron rule. Okay, this is another example, CO2CO5. Okay, so it will also obey the 18 electrons rule. The 19 electrons in a CO metal, and the 3 terminal bond which gives the total 6 electron, and 2 bridge bond which is give the 2 of each, so it will also contributed, and 1 COCO bond will give the 1 electron. Okay, so the EAN rule cannot differentiate the structure of compound, but it can provide the possibilities or the investigation of the structure of the compound. Okay, so the EAN of it obeys the 18, if the complex obeys the 18 electron rule, okay, it is completely not related with the electronic configuration of the complex. Okay, and the summary of EAN, what is the summary of EAN? That it works only for the d orbital metal. It does not apply on, you know, on a 5f orbital. Okay, and it works best for the compound with the transition metal having the low oxidation state. The ligands which are good sigma bond donor and the pi acceptor utilize all the valencies orbital, and thus it's such compound obeys the 18 electron rule or EAN rule. The complexes which obtain a combination of sigma donor and pi acceptor conform this rule. For example, CrNH3 whole price CO3 and CrNeta6C6H6CO3. This is the sandwich compound. And the compounds which obey this rule are kinetically inert to the substitution reaction. The this rule also expects that the two ends of the transition series, whereas the ND, which is N plus 1 S and N plus 1 P valence orbital, are less well matched in the energy. This rule provides for the production of the structure relativity and the reaction mechanism. Okay, thank you very much.